Panginoon namin. Hallelujah, Lord God. Pinupuri ka namin, O God, sa hapon ito, Panginoon. And thank you for your holy presence in the midst of this house, O God, in your house, Panginoon. We thank you, Lord, for the freedom that we have in this place to worship you freely, Lord. And thank you, Lord, for the opportunity that we are gathered together, O God, because of our purpose to glorify your name to the highest. Lord, hindi dalangin po ako na kanoon ng Panginoon na magagamit sa inakatulong ng Iglesia. Patuloy mo pong pagpalain ang mga kumpanya ng aming pinagtatrabahuan, O God, and even for the leaders, and even for this country. Because apart from you, we are not. Purihin ka, Panginoon, sa hapon. Jesus, we pray.
Thank you very much. This time we are going to have a celebration of for the life of a sister who's been with us and has been sustained by the Lord sa lugar na ito, who's also living back to the Philippines. So we'll be calling on Sister Nida. I think my Sister Nida. Okay. Sige po. And happy welcome also our elders. Our chairman, Elder Cesar Montoya, to help us in recognizing our sister. Si Sister Nida Calyon. I nag-umpisa po nag-work dito and has been sustained by the Lord for the last 33 years. Can you imagine? Ano? Ito po yung mga panahon, naka-belyo pa lang ang sinasakyan nila pagpunta sa town center. Kaya ako tinawag ko si Kuya Cesar sapagkat magkabas daw po sila yung mga panahon na yun. And really praise the Lord sa buhay ni Sister Nida. Ano, imagine 33 years. Last night, we had a good time. And those special people na nakasama niya sa lugar na ito, really, said something about her sa kanyang nakalipas na maraw na rito. It's really a joy for this church to have our sister to be a part of this family. Ano? And it's not easy to work outside of our country. Alam natin yan. It's one of us are longing whenever we have our vacation. But to be able to be staying for 33 years, can you imagine working here abroad? More than half of her life was spent in this place. Di ba? Can you imagine yung kalahati ng kanyang buhay, inubol niya rito sa lugar na ito. But the Lord has been good, has been faithful sa kanya. And so I think it's just proper to hear some words from her as a thanksgiving to the Lord. Bago po natin siya ito na lagi.
Very simple lang ang buhay ng UAE. Pati yung mga roundabout, simple lang. Yung kalsada, simple lang, especially in Dubai. I worked there in Dubai first when I arrived here. So we can see the seashore from far. Makikita namin ang beach. Ngayon, wala na, puno na ng buildings. I cannot even see where I worked before. Marami ng buildings sa palipaligid. So, we really are thankful for this country, for sharing their wealth, and we thank God also for blessing this country so that many expatriates came here to work. Marami, 126 countries are here, and different nationalities are here in this country to work and share their blessings. And we thank God for that. So, hindi lang yung mga sila lang yung kanilang pera, sinishare din nila sa atin. And I have experienced also the generosity of our Sheikh Zayed, the father of the Sheikh Khalifa now. He was a very generous man because he doesn't discriminate the Muslims or Christians or Hindus. He welcomed everybody here in his country. And when he went to United States for an operation, he was sick that time, that was in 1997. He went to Mayo Clinic in Minnesota, Mayo Clinic. And when he came back, he was well. He gave all bonus, 1 month bonus salary for all the government lawyers. Of course, now we don't, in the near future, I don't think they will do that again. Kasi minsan lang mangyari. And in the succeeding years, he also gave, but ano na, napin na namin na sa local na nila bitigay, no longer to us. Yes. Kaya makikita natin yung changes as years go by, na hindi naman lang dito. It's also affecting the Middle East and also the world, yung recession. And of course, mag-improve din ang hindi naman talagang ang crisis, mag-improve naman sa lahat. So anyway, I thank God for His faithfulness, for sustaining me all these years. I'm alone here. I go home every, in the previous years, I used to go home twice a year. Kasi sa government, meron yung institution na generous naman sa amin. Pwede kang umuwi ng dalawang beses, isang taon. Yung isang, yung once, libre ang pamasahin, yung isang uwi mo, ikaw ang babayad. So, that's what I have been doing before. So, ngayon, this is the time to go, sabi ng Panginoon. Tama na siguro. Dapat pupunta yung anak ko dito para ano kaya lang. The healthcare sector is not as promising as it used to be at this time. Siguro in the coming days or months, magiging okay, ma-stabilize ang health sector. So anyway, baka iba ang plano ng Panginoon sa kanya. I'm still hoping and praying na makapunta siya sa, makapagtrabaho rin siya kahit hindi man dito. Maraming salamat sa inyo dahil kayo ang aking pamilya dito sa UAE. I spend more time with you than my husband, than my children. So, kayo ang family ko dito and have been a blessing to me. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Thank you also for our pastor who also uprooted from his comfortable life in the Philippines and came here to be with us. Hindi rin siya, parang si Abraham din na na-abroad sa Iraq, sa ano na, basta lang pumunta ka doon. And not knowing what will happen to him here in the UAE, basta lang pumunta rin. Maraming salamat sa iyo and your family. Kasi, you're also a blessing to FECC, maraming salamat. Thank you very much. And dahil you also came here and we dedicated your lives and your family, marapat lang na mahalin natin sila at support natin sa pag-stay sa UAE. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. For the past 2 years na nakasama ko sa Tinida, alam niya yung mga nagyayari sa church, sa iglesia na ito. And he's still there. No, for 33 years,
na nandito siya, supported the church, the Filipino Evangelical Christian Church. And malunod ko man kami sa pag-uwi mo. At you know na masaya-masaya yung pamilya mo sa Pilipinas na makasama mo na sila. And in behalf of the Filipino Evangelical Christian Church, our pastors, our elders, and all the members of this church, we give to you this certificate of appreciation for faithfully serving the Lord at Filipino Evangelical Christian Church through the exercise of our spiritual gifts. This recognition is given to Sister Nina Calleon Ugali this 18th day of November 2016 at the Main Worship Center, Mrs. Compound, signed by our lab pastors.
Last night, we have a wonderful time of fellowship with Sister Nina and her G group. That's the reason why this church is really geared towards being your family here while you're working here in Alain. Ano, ito pong gusto natin, that you can really feel that there's a family that can support you while working here. Ano, and we are thankful that Sister Nina really been with us for the many, many years. Iglesia ay talagang narito at nilunod sa Panginoon. And it's amazing, maybe just to encourage that to Sister Nina, that the Lord Jesus Christ was also had only 33 years ng kanyang existence, ano po, and then He left. So, He was taken by the Lord. But now, you will be taken by the Lord to be given a rest also sa Pilipinas. Ibig sabihin may magagawa pa sa inyo ang Panginoon. Dito, pinagpahinga lang kayo ng Panginoon. So, but 33 years is not easy. How I wish each one of us here na narito sa loob ng building na ito will be able to at least reach that level na tatagal tayo. Ano po, sa pamilya ko at also sa pagtatrabaho ko to help our family. So, God bless you at Inida. We are looking for it. We'll continue to pray for you. Just like other members who are already been in the Philippines right now. Marami po sa kanila, they still keep in touch sa ating FB site, sa ating mga groups, lalo po yung mga G-groups. Kaya we encourage you to be a part of a G-group dahil this is your family while here in UAE. Ano po. Tonight, we'll be extending another fellowship ay masalamat party para kay Ate Nina doon po sa ating fellowship center. After our fellowship outside, meron pa rin po tayong magsasalo-salo doon sa ating fellowship center. So, we invite you to join us para sa mga panahon na medyo ma-cherish ni Ate Nina yung kasama tayo sa family. So, let's go to our visitors right now. We have some visitors who are with us for the first time. Marami po ito. Let's recognize si Charisse Aprosta. Are you here? Charisse, welcome. Visita po siya niya. Yes, alright. Number two is si John O. Hermoso. And si John O. Welcome. Alright. Si Maria Teresa de la Cruz. Si Leila Egamino. Si Jenny Poa. Si Richelle Jacob. So, welcome po sa FECC. Some of our people will just approach you and give you some token as a first time visitor. And they'll invite you to a particular place na po saan they can welcome you more. Kaya po, we would like to invite you to join them. So, aliyahan lang po nila ngayon na kayong bahagi. They will just stay standing up and moving to another place so that we can be welcome more. For some announcements, these are the people serving next week. Of course, mababasa niyo po yan, I hope. Si Brother Ray will be our presider and Sister Veronica will be our song leader. And Brother Mark, Loy, and then the Deputy of Manila will be our Tithes and Offering ushers. And our prayer in intercession. Nakikita niyo po si Gloria. Nag-fellowship in church next week sa Tuba G Group. Okay? At today yun. Next week is Marcanian. Every Sunday, we still have our prayer together sa ating fellowship center. So, we invite you to come and join us praying and worshiping the Lord. Sister Alta will be presided, Brother Bob Mandubata will be our speaker. Ito po yung ating mga G-groups. If you happen to not be a part of any G-groups, we invite you to be a part of one of these G-groups. May contact po yung mga tao in charge. Mahalaga po yan mga kapatid, it's like, just like this, katulad nyan kapag meron kami, meron tayong kapatid na paalis, we would like you to enjoy that fellowship of, in a G-group. Sila rin po yung nagbibigay ng special fellowship, and just like a farewell party like this, sila po yung nakapuna talaga mag-provide. So, we'd like you to be a part of our G-groups. Meron pa po ba? Pagkatapos muna ating worship nila. Next Friday will be our Church Workers Appreciation Week. So there's a special occasion where you recognize how those people are serving the Lord. In doing what we have been discussing for the last 2 months, we would like for you to recognize the people who are serving in this church as a gesture of sabihin natin pasasalamat din sa kalama paglilingkod na ginagawa voluntary sa Panginoon. So please come next Friday. Then our congregational picture will be taken on December 2. This is the first Friday of the month. For our calendar next year, we have a calendar every year. And we will be taking one big picture pagkatapos po ng worship dito. But at the same time, there's another one during our sports fest na nakaset din po yan that week. So, tandaan niyo po yung date then for our calendar next year. We are going to have our picture taking on the first Friday of the month. So, pakisunod nyo na po yung magaganda rin yung damit. Ano, yung mga pag-snow ninyo. Para na sa ganun, we can feel at least na para tayo nasa Canada. Alright? Okay. Our FECC Family Sports Fest is also on the first Friday of the month, or first week of the month. Now, it is set on December 3, that the venue is final, and we are thankful sa Panginoon because we're able to get this venue which is at the back of Palen Mall, ano, dito sa Nicod. Yes, malaki po itong venue na to, better than the other last year. However, it was announced, I haven't talked yet to our elders, it was announced that the holiday for the boat, for the private sector is on December 1 and 2. While for the government, is on December 1 to 3. Okay? Nakaset po yung aming sports fest on December 3, which is Saturday. Yan. Ang concern po ng aking leaders dyan is that baka maraming papasok na nag-work sa private sector on December 3. Kaya we're still considering whether we are going to move that on December 1, which is Thursday, which happens to be a holiday. Ano? But we would like to inform you ahead of time so that you can set this appointment sa ating sports fest. This is a once a year activity that we do, and last year, marami po tayong kasama na lumalo ito. It was a very, very exciting fellowship. And our theme for this year is that FECC Family Sports Fest, Fun, Fitness, and Fellowship. So, alam po, excited po yung maraming gusto ng sports to be able to join this. So please be aware, we still have 2 weeks to go, but kapag ito'y na-move sa December 1, that would be Thursday. So we do not know kung pwede po yan possible mag-move to sa venue. Our concern is on the venue actually, if this is available. So, kaya we'd like to inform you immediately if there's any changes, we're going to post that. But definitely, it is set on December 3. Any changes will be just on the December 1, which just happens to be a holiday for both the private and public sector. Okay, so away na po tayo lahat. The private sector is December 1 and 2 ang holiday. Amen to ba? Okay, so alam niyo na po yan. And December 1 to 3 is for the public sector. So as much as possible, we'd like to have as much able to come and be able to join. Wala po tayong mag-miss. So kaya, we are announcing that to you. Now, and also, kapag wala po kayong G-group, kindly release your names, ating secretary. Kaya po, mahalaga po ito sapagkat the reason why we keep reminding that you have to be a part of G-group because most of the time, you grow through the G-groups. And activities like this, a sports fest, it's easy for you to be placed in one particular group and be identified. Kapag wala po kayong G-group, ay nangyarapan yung ating mga leaders sa sports o sa anumang activity to really identify you and place you in the right position para lang sa ganun. Eh, hindi po kayo ma-miss. We do not want to miss really anybody sa ating kalagitnaan. So, we would like to, again, encourage you to be a part of the G-group. And our Christmas party is set on December 23. Dito po sa Oasis Pagkakaya, we're just doing it outside. At meron din po tayo sa Ibo, ano, sa 31, year-end party. Pero the venue still to be announced. Ang ating pong position for secretary, who wants to be to volunteer, identification pa rin po yan. So we'd like you to consider that if you're willing to serve the Lord in response to our team for these last 2 months. Okay. Wala na po tayong announcement. Except for that, yung ating mga birthday celebrators, meron pa po ba tayong nami-miss yan? Okay. Yan. Last, November 15, si Brother Jun Almorado. Last November 16, Brother Jerry Lin. Okay. Si Sister Manels. Si Brother Raymond. Okay, November 16 din. And today, si Zia. Okay. Daughter na ating chairman. And on the 22nd, si Elder Bong Mandubatan. And si Chloe Ibai, also on the same day. And on the 24th, si Brother Jun Barnares. Okay, so yung ating mga kalalakihan ay magdaraos ng mga kaarawan. Okay, salamat sa Panginoon sila yung umabot sa ganitong panahon ng alam buhay. Salamat naman. Okay, so let's sing a birthday song for them. Chinese businessman na nagdaraos ng kanyang kaarawan. So, nakakita sa celebration ito. Okay, I think the sports committee will meet after ng ating masalama party siguro. Ang ating mga sports kasi malapit na po yung ating sports. It's really, really big event for this church. We enjoy so much our sports, annual sports activity. So, we hope that you can come and join us on the same day. Okay. So, yun lamang po. Again, after this, we're going to have our fellowship outside. Spend a night to meet those na hindi po nakakasama sa G-group naman. Kasi we need to really know one another. So, let's request everyone to please rise as we close in our song. Let's give back the Lord the honor because indeed He's magnificent. He's our God.
God is good.